Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we come before you. We want to thank you for your faithfulness. We want to thank you for your love. We want to thank you, God, for this is the day that you have made, and we are instructed to rejoice and to be glad in it. And so, Lord, we purpose our hearts and our minds to be glad in it, and we will rejoice despite whatever might be awaiting us. Lord God, we thank you that you are God and that you have it all in control. And so we place this day before you. We place every obstacle and every challenges that we will face before you, Lord. And we say, have thine own way. Have thine own way, Lord. You take the wheel and you steer. You lead and direct us. And we will go where you send us. Hallelujah. We thank you, God, in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise the Lord. This morning, for a quick point of discussion, I invite you to go with me to the book of Judges chapter 11, and we'll read the first five verses. And the word of God reads, "Now Jephthah the Gileadite was a mighty man of valor, and he was the son of an harlot, and Gilead begat Jephthah. And Gilead's wife bare him sons, and his wife's sons grew up, and they thrust out Jephthah, and said unto him, Thou shalt not inherit in our father's house, for thou art the son of a strange woman. Then Jephthah fled from his brethren and dwelt in the land of Tob. And there were gathered vain men to Jephthah, and went out with him. And it came to pass in process of time that the children of Ammon made war against Israel. And it was so that when the children of Ammon made war against Israel, the elders of Gilead went to fetch Jephthah out of the land of Tob." Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. Glory be to God. We see in the text where it tells us of Jephthah, this young man, was the son of an harlot and rejected by his brothers and his brethren and was cast out of his own father's house. While he was a son, they didn't see him fit to inherit the same blessings or inheritance that they were. Because of his status of being a child through an extramarital affair, he was rejected. He was rejected by his brothers and counted as worthless, but God called him. The Bible says he was a mighty man of valor. I know that sometimes we can't rationalize, we can't identify with who God says that we are because of our immediate circumstances or situation. Because of what we might be going through, because of some ties that we may have entangled ourselves with. But this morning, I want to say to us that God has use for you. And it doesn't matter where you see yourself. It doesn't matter how others see you. I want to speak into your spirit and remind you that God has use for you. Amen. And so, how does someone rationalize being called a mighty man of valor, but yet face rejection or even be ostracized? The only way to deal with this is to know and understand your worth based on who God says you are. If God is our maker and he's our designer, then he's the one who gets to define us. And he's the one who gets to tell us who we are. But the only way we can know who we are is when we interact with the word of God, when we study the word of God, when we get to know the word of God. When we draw nigh to God, God will draw nigh to us. And in that drawing, in that spending time with him, he will reveal to us who we are. And when we know who we are and to whom we belong, then we can truly understand our worth. My brothers and sisters, God has use for you. Hallelujah. God said he was a mighty man of valor, but he needed to get out of his place of comfort. And from amongst those whom he was most comfortable with, his brothers. And he needed to go among strangers before he could appreciate his worth. The Bible tells us that Jephthah fled to the land of Tob. And while there in Tob, there were men, vain men, the Bible says, who would be drawn to him and he would lead them. In other words, he were leading a band of rebels. But let us not focus on the fact that they were rebels, but let us focus on the fact that he was leading a band or a gang. And so Jephthah had to leave his place of comfort. He had to leave where he was supposed to receive his inheritance and go to a strange land, the land of Tob. And in that land, he was developing his leadership. In that land, he was being pressed. In that land, he was being trained. And so, brothers and sisters, when we go through circumstances and difficulties in our life, when that which we think we deserve, others take away from us and treat us as if we are worthless or we were nothing, and we find ourselves in strange places or we find ourselves being alone, I want to remind you, you are not alone, but God is right there with you. And if you can just trust God and trust the process, then God can prune you, God can squeeze you, God can cause something beautiful to come out of your nothingness or out of your situation based on how you're feeling, because God has already stated, he's a mighty man of valor. God is saying the same thing about some of us. God is saying the same thing about you. But you're not feeling like that because your friends make you feel less than a person. Your family makes you feel as if you're no good. Even the church makes you feel like you're no good. But I want to tell you this morning, God has use for you. We were told that it was in the land of Tob, a good land, a good place for Jephthah. Because it was in that land he was able to gain his leadership and he sharpened his warfare skill set. The Bible says that Israel and his brethren were facing war against the Ammonites, and there was no one to lead them. But they remembered Jephthah and begged him to return and lead them. When man don't know or even understand your worth, God still have use for you. Sometimes we get frustrated with the process or in the process, but oftentimes it requires us to go to our place of Tob, into the land of Tob. And in that land, in that place, it is best, it is the best thing that could happen to some of us. We see here in the text that it is the best thing that happened to Jephthah. While he was there, his reputation was known. And so oftentimes when we are out of our comfort zone, we are forced to depend only on God and no one else. We can't use friends as a crutch. We can't use family as a crutch. And so we have to depend on God. And in so doing, in these moments, our faith is strengthened. Our faith in God is built. And our relationship with God, our dependency on God is strengthened. Jephthah's reputation of being a competent leader was recognized by those that rejected him. And so in Psalms 118 and verse 22, it tells us the stone that the builders rejected has now become the cornerstone. Yes, my brothers and sisters, Not because the world has rejected you mean that you are no use. But I want to tell you this morning that despite you feeling like a reject, God, the Almighty God, has use for you. In John chapter 4, it tells of the story of the Samaritan woman who was married and divorced 5 times, and she was now living with a man who wasn't her husband. She was a Samaritan, and so the Jews had nothing to do with her, wanted nothing, and they had nothing to do with the Jews. But God took time out of his time to step into her time and into that interval, to interrupt her time, to tell her and to cause her to know that he has use for her. He introduced himself to her. He asked her for a drink. And he engaged her by saying, if you knew who I was, you would want the drink, because I can give you the drink of life. Brothers and sisters, friends and loved ones, we are looking to our families. We are looking to reap, to inherit our family blessing. And they want nothing to do with us. I want to tell you, don't spend too much time invested in them, but I want you to spend time invested in God. You can never lose with God, because God has use for you. And the time spent with God will be worth it, not just in this life, but in the life to come. Don't pay so close attention to what is going on around you. Don't look at your family history and how you came into the world. Listen, God is not holding that against you. God has use for you now. People always hold the things that you have done in front of you. But in God, there's a place of repentance. There's a place of forgiveness. And there's a place of forgetfulness. God says that I've thrown your sins into the seas of forgetfulness, never to remember them anymore. Friends will bring them back up in your face, but God says never to remember them anymore. We have a problem because we find it difficult to forgive ourselves. But if God forgives you, if you're having trouble forgiving yourself this morning, I want to remind you that God is greater than your heart, because God has use for you. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Man will judge you based on your past deeds, but Jesus have use for you. Jephthah was considered an illegitimate son, but God declared him to be a mighty man of valor. I want to speak into your spirit and tell you, you are a mighty man of valor. You don't feel it, you don't see it, you can't identify with it. But I want to remind you, you are a mighty man. You are a mighty woman of valor, and God has use for you. Only God knows your true purpose. And we can only walk in our true purpose after we have spent some time in the land of Tob. Jesus does not hold your past against you, because he wants you to receive the revelation of who he is, so that you in turn can understand who you are in him and really begin to walk in your true purpose. Because only when you're walking in your true purpose will you be satisfied and fulfilled. Because God has use for you. I know sometimes we are beaten down by the cares of this world, by family issues and relationship issues. We are dejected and feel rejected. But I want to speak into your spirit this morning. I want to tell you, God has use for you. You don't feel like you are usable. You don't feel worthy or even like a mighty man or a mighty woman, one with purpose. But I want to reassure you this morning that it is not too late for you to open up. It says, God, here I am. God, I want to know my purpose. God, I want to be used by you, because God has use for you. You are never too far gone. Never. Doesn't matter what you have done. You're never too far gone. God has use for you. The Bible tells us that God says that he's married to the backslider. Yes, you. You were walking once with him and you're falling by the wayside. But it is for you he came. He has use for you. Hallelujah. He wants you to be like the woman who encountered him at the well. And when she encountered him and she received the revelation and she understood that this was the Christ, she ran to tell everybody. She ran to evangelize. Brothers and sisters, listen, people might not want to talk to you now, but God has use for you. You can tell them of Jesus Christ. You can tell them, come see a man who has changed me. Come see the man who has turned my life around. God has use for you. And so Isaiah, like the Samaritan woman, experienced the presence and the glory of God. In Isaiah 6, it says, in the year that King Uzziah died. I don't know who or what is your King Uzziah, what is stopping you, or what is holding you back, or what is causing you not to see him for who he is and understand your worth. But when Isaiah saw him, Isaiah says, woe is me, for I am undone. I am a man of unclean lips. I dwell among the people of unclean lips. But the seraphims took the coal of the altar and touched his lips. And in that touching, in that purification, now a couple sentences down, a couple verses down, the Lord is asking, whom shall I send? Whom will go? And Isaiah, who saw himself as a sinful man, one who is undone and one who has unclean lips and dwell amongst the people of unclean lips, says, here I am, Lord, send me. God has use for you. You might feel undone. You might find yourself like Isaiah. But I don't want you to stay in the negative. I want you to see that Isaiah said to the Lord, here I am, send me. Friends and loved ones, you can be touched by God this morning, where you can identify and begin to walk in your true purpose, because God has use for you. Your mouth might be filthy, your life messy, rejected by society, cast out by family, and ostracized by your peers. Don't lose hope this morning. I stopped by to tell you, God wants to purge you. He wants to sanctify you. He wants to reveal himself to you, because he, God, has use for you. I pray this morning that as you encounter this word, that you will be like the woman at the well who will drop your water pot. Forget about what others think and say of you, and that you will look to God. You will run and testify his goodness, because God has use for you. Mighty God, we thank you this morning. We praise you. We honor you. I pray, God, that your word as your people will hear this word and as they will interact with your word, God, I pray that your Holy Spirit will interact with them. And God, that you will pull them out of that place of complacency. God, you will pull them out of that place of self-pity, that you pull them out of that place where they're feeling as if they're worthless and, oh God, there are no use. I pray this morning that you will touch their minds and that you will cause them to change their thought process and to know that in your sight they are worthy. God, in your hands, they are useful. Oh God Almighty, I pray this morning that they will begin to identify with your word, where you have called them, oh God, by name, where you have called them and declared that they are mighty man, a mighty woman of valor. Oh God, I pray this morning that they will interact with your word, where your word declared that they are sons and daughters. Oh God, we know that you didn't come for the perfect, but you came for the reject, oh God, and the misfit, that God, that you can use them and use us for your glory. Heavenly Father, we pray on this morning that even now, Lord, as we surrender ourselves to you, that Lord God Almighty, if you can use anything, Lord, you can use us. And so I pray this morning that we will come to a place where we can know you for who you are, and we can know our true worth. Oh God, those who are struggling with self-worth, those that are struggling, oh God Almighty, with self-identity, I pray this morning that they will find themselves in you. Lord, those who have lost inheritance, those who have lost families because of, oh God, how they started. How they came into this world, may they understand that that means nothing, Lord. But it is how they finish. I pray this morning that your Holy Spirit will get a hold of our minds and that you will touch us and cause us to know that each and every one of us, oh God, is usable by you, and that you desire to use us for your glory. God, we thank you that you have not counted us out, but you still have use for us. We give you praise this morning. We give you thanks. In Jesus' name, may you continue to bless this radio station, that it will impact lives for your glory. In Jesus' precious name, amen, amen, and amen. God bless you this morning.